योर टेस्ट आई हैव स्टॉप्ड एट बैंकर्स एल्गोरिथम. सो बैंकर्स एल्गोरिथम व्हाई डू वी रिक्वायर दिस इज दे आर यूजिंग टू चेक वेदर देर इज अ डेड लॉक इन द एल्गोरिथम और नॉट. The resources, whatever we allocated, do we have a deadlock in that or not? For that, we are using a banker's algorithm. So, what is banker's algorithm? They may say whether banker algorithm is detection algorithm or what. So, deadlock detection algorithm, yes. Banker's algorithm is a deadlock detection algorithm, checking whether the deadlock is present in the particular graph or not. Okay. So then what is banker's algorithm? A resource allocation graph is not applicable when there are multiple instances for each resource. So here the banker's algorithm addresses the situation, but it is less efficient. We have seen some more algorithm, but this comparing with Dow's algorithm, this is less efficient. The name was chosen because the algorithm could be used for a banking system. So why the name is given banker's algorithm is this algorithm can be used or implemented or mostly it will be used for a banking system to ensure that the bank never allocates its available cash such that it can no longer satisfy the needs of all its customers. When a process enters the system, it must declare the maximum number of instances of each resources that resources type that it may need. So now take an example, three of us. One is Asta, one is Nishant, and one is me. Three of us are there. So if I consider three are different processors, then what I'll say, I will say I want five CPUs, I want one textbook and one printer. So what did I say? How much things I want. So that's what I'm saying, number of instances. So what is instances? Instances means different types of resources. The number may not exceed the total number of resources in the system. So we'll see one algorithm, one example, it will be clear for you. When a user requests a set of resources, the system must determine whether the allocation of these resources will leave the system in a safe state. So what does it mean? What is safe and unsafe? Unsafe means there is a deadlock occurring. Safe state means, so we are saying in our last this slide you can see what is deadlock, what is safe and what is unsafe. Safe means there is no deadlock. What is unsafe? There is a deadlock. That's the reason we say it is a safe or unsafe. If the resource are allocated, otherwise the process must wait until some other process release the enough resource. So the data structure what we are using in the banker's algorithm are, so we see how much available, what is the maximum I require, or what is the maximum resources Asta requires to complete her work, or how much resources Nishant is required. That's what we say, available maximum. How many are allocated already? How much resources Asta have given? So that's what allocation need. Still how much she need? That's what the need explains to us. So available, a vector of length m indicate number of available resources. How many are there right now with me? That is what available. For that, what we say, we take one array and we say that avail of j equal to k. There are k instances of resource type rj available. What is maximum? An n cross m matrix defines the maximum demand for each process. So now Asta may say, may ask, I want one CPU, I want one laptop, I want one book. So what she is saying, what are her maximum requirements? Allocation, how much I can allocate. And n cross m matrix defines the number of resources currently allocated to each process. If allocation of I comma j equal to k, then p of j is currently allocated k instances of rj. Need, how many we require. So the same what I've explained is just an explanation of this. What is banker algorithm has two parts. One is safety of the algorithm. It is found for finding out whether the system is in a safe state or not. So what does the safe state or not say to us? If it is safe means what we say, it is in a deadlock. So if it is safe, means deadlock is not occurring. The steps used to complete this algorithm is, let initially we use two arrays. One we are calling it as a work, another one we are calling it as a finish. These are vectors of length m and n respectively. Work equal to available, what did we say? Initially we say how many are available with me. Then finish always start, because before we have not started, the finish array should be false. How many such process I have? Now, just now I told we may have started with three process. One me, one Nishant, one Ashta. How many process? Three. Like that, for I equal to 1, 2, 3, repeat this for an I such that bottom. Did we complete allocation for all? Did allocation for me is completed? Till the allocation of Asta is completed, the allocation of Nishant is completed, that's what. If it is, then we say false. How much I require, need? If so, such I exist, go to step 4. So if your work is completed, then complete, then go back to 4. Work equal to work plus allocation, finish equals to true, go to step 2. If not, then go back. That's what the algorithm says. Along with that, resource request algorithm. It says how much is my request. So for this, how many it is requesting for 10, but I don't have 10. What is my maximum limit? I have 5. That's what here. Always the process request should be equal to k, then the process pi wants k instance of resources rj. The request always should be less than need. Then request of should be available in the resources. That's what it says the algorithm. We see the example, then it will be clear. So this we'll come back, because here it is not clearly. We'll come back, because this is a little bit fast track solving of the algorithm. So this is a step by step procedure. So now you can see, what is this Banker's algorithm? Banker's algorithm is to detect whether there is a deadlock or not, and trying to see the deadlock should be avoided in such a way that which sequence I have to do, whether my requirement should be completed first, or should Asta should be executed first, or Nishant first executed. This way we decide. So deciding the sequence may avoid a deadlock. So let us assume that right now A is how much we have. What is a A value we have in the one second. There is this maximum, where I can do this maximum. There is a maximum window. Okay. So now in this case you can see here how much Banker's algorithm, what is the total? Total is A equals to 10. A is what? Assume that it is CPU. How many CPUs right now we have? 10. What is B? B may be some memory. How many I have available? 5. What is C? C is printer. How many I have? 7. How many processors are there? 1, P1, P2, P3, P4, P5. How many processors? P5. What is allocation? How much I have already given to 5 processors? That's what allocation. What maximum P1 is required? What is the maximum need for P1? 753 is required. Suppose I assume that P1 is Asta. So how many resources Asta wants to maximum to complete her work? She wants 7. A, what is A? We have told CPUs. What is 5? 5, we told memory. What is C3? Printer. She wants her work to be completed if she is given 5 A's, 7 A's, 5 B's, 3, 6. That's what it means here. So available, we'll come back to that, these columns next. So the same way P2. Now Nishant, how much he wants resources to complete his work? He wants 3 A's, he wants 2 B's, he wants 2 C's. So that's what 3-2-2 is required for Nishant to complete his work. The same way, me, how many I want? I want 9 A's. I don't want any B's. I want 2 C's. So if I have given this many, I will complete my work. Similarly, 2 more people. So 2 more people who, so P4 required 4 A's, 2 B's, 2 C's. Then how, what is P5? One more resource, one more thing. 5, if you give A5's, B3's, C3's, then he'll complete his work. Okay, this is what is called as a maximum needs. How much right now I have available free? A is 10, B is 5, C is 7. Okay, now add all this. So before they could come, already we have given for P1, already how much resources I have given? We have given already B. Means Asta is already given 1 B. The same way, Nishant is already given 2 A. And me is already assigned or allocated with 3 A's and 2 C's. In the same way, P4 is already allocated with 2 A's, 1 B, 1 C. The same way, 5 is already allocated. Processor is allocated, P5 is allocated with 2 C's. So in the same way, add all these. How many we have already allocated? 7 A's we have already allocated. How many B's we have allocated already? We have allocated 2. And 5 C's already we have allocated. So how many we have? 10, 5, 7. That's what here 10 A's I have. 10 B, 5 B's is there. 7 C's are there. Out of this, we have already allocated 7 to 5. Then how much is remaining? How much is available for us? You can see the red color available. Current available, that is a next column. After maximum need, we have this column. So in this column, A is how many I have? 10. How many is already allocated A? 7. So 10 minus 7 is what? 3. And the same way B. How many was there? 5 was there with me. Already 2 is allocated. To whom? 2, 1 for P1, 1 for P4. Already allocated B. That's what 5 minus 2 is 3. Then C, how many are there? C, we have already allocated 5. How many I was having initially? I was having 7. 7 minus 5 is 2. Yes? So this is 3-3-2 is currently available with me, with the processor. Now, remaining needs. How much remaining I have to give to Asta, because already I have given 1 D for Asta. Now how much I have to give? That's what we are calculating here. How many A's she wants? She wants 7. So 7 minus 0. I have to give how many A's to Asta? 7. So in the same way, come back B. How many she requires? 5. Already I have given 1 to her. So 5 minus 1 is 4. Then 3 minus 0 is 3. So how much resources Asta required to complete her work? 7, 4, 3 is the required resources for Asta. Asta means, now I am saying it is P1. Similarly, how much Nishant is required to complete his work? So already I have assigned something. That's what. But now how available is how much for us? So available is 3, 3, 2. This is available right now. So how many was there? 3. 3 minus 2 is what? 1. So 2 minus 0, 2. Then 2 minus 0, 2. So I should give 2, 2, 2 to complete Nishant's work. How much resources I have to give to Nishant? 1, 2, 2 still required to complete his work. 1, 2, 2. 1 is 2 B's, 2 C's for Nishant to complete his work. Similarly, how much I require to complete my work? So I require 9 minus 3. Already I have been given 3. Already C's I have given 2. So that's what, 9 minus 3 is 6. Then 0 minus 0 is 0. Then 2 minus 2 is 0. the how many still I require to complete my work. I should have given 6 resources of A. I don't want any B. I don't want any C to complete my work. That's what P3 will be doing. Similar fashion, P4. So P4, how much still it requires? It requires 4 minus 2. 4 minus 2 is 2. Then 2 minus 1 is 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. So 2, 1, 1 is required for processor P4 to complete its work. So next come back. Same way for P5. So P5 is required. How many is still left for us? Still left is 5 minus 0, 3 minus 0, 3 minus 0. So I will be available. This is required remaining 5, 3, 1. This is what I have. 5 minus 0 is 5. 3 minus 0 is 3. 3 minus 2 is 1. So 5, 3, 1 resources is required for P5 to complete its work. Yes, so that's what here it says. Okay, now come back. How many processors are there? P1, P2, P3, P4, P5 are the processors. Okay, now how much is available with us now? 3, 3, 2 is available. How much is available with me right now? I have only 3 A's, 3 B's, 2 A's. Okay, now can I give for P1? Do I have 7? How much 7? P1 requires how many A's? 7. How many B's P1 require? 4. How many C's? 3. How much I have right now? I have only 3 A's, 3 B's, 2 C's I have. Can I give the resource? I don't have to satisfy for A. Okay. Now leave A, leave P1. Now come to P2. So P2, how much resources it requires? 1, 2, 2. How much is available with me? 3, 3, 2. So yes, I can give 1 from 3. 2 B's, yes, I can give. 2 A's I can give. So when I give 1, 2, 2 for P2, the P2 work will be completed. Yes, P2 work will be completed. So after P2 completes its work, whichever we have allocated for P2, it will return me back. So what did we allocate? We have allocated 2 A's. Yes, we have allocated 2 A's. That's what here in this column you can see. So if I give 1, 1, 2, 2, 1 A's, 2 B's, 2 C's, if I give for Nishant, he will complete his work. As he completes his work, he will return me whatever I have allocated here initially. So initially, right now, how much resources I have already have? 3, 3, 2. So 3, 3, 2 I have. And Nishant gave me back because he completed his work. So he has completed. He has given me 2, 0, 0. Add this, I'll get 5, 3, 2. So this 5, 3, 2 is right now available CPUs. I have 5 CPUs right now. I have 3 memories right now. I have 2 printers. Because Nishant completed his work and he returned me 2 A's. What is 2 A's? 2 A's is CPUs. So I have added whatever Nishant has given to me. So that is what the total 5, 3, 2. Here you can see 5, 3, 2. Okay. Now available what I have? Not 332, now I have 532. Why 532? Because Nishant gave me 2 A's. So I have added to this. So I am getting 532. Okay. Now come back and check. Go for P3. So P3, how much I have to give for P3 to complete its work? I have to give 6 A's. B not required. C not required. Do I have 6 A's? No, I don't have. Okay, so now leave it. So the same sequence, what we can do is first I can execute P2. Now come back for P4. P3 I cannot do because it is asking 6 CPUs. Right now I don't have 6. So leave for P3. Now come back for P4. P for how many it is required? 2, 1, 1. So what is this 2, 1, 1? 2 CPUs is required for P4. 1 memory is required for P4. 1 printer is required for P4. Is it available with me? Yes, it is available. How much is available? I have 5, 3, 2. So 5, 3, 2 is available for me. Yes, then I can execute P4. So if I give 2, 1, 1 for P4, it will complete its work. Then it completes its work. What is that thing? Whatever we have allocated, it will give me back. That's what here you can add. 5, 3, 2 is available with me. When I have given 2, 1, 1 for P4, it completed its work. Whatever resources it was having, it will give me back. Now add 5 plus 2 is 7. 3 plus 1 is 4. 2 plus 1 is 3. So it has given me whatever is there with P4, because P4 completed its work and given back the resources. What it was having? It was having 2 CPUs, 1 memory, 1 printer. So now add, which is already I was having. I was having 5, 3, 2. Now add 2, 1, 1 to that. Then you will get 5, 4, 3 as your remaining or balance what I have after P4 is completed. That's what down you can see save sequence. Now we have executed P2. Now we have executed P4. Now check for P5. Process P5 is executed. How much resources P5 is required? P5 is required. 5, 3, 1. How much is available with me? Right now available with me is 7, 4, 3. 7, 4, 3 is available with the available, total available. What is P5 required? 5, 3, 1. Yes, then I can satisfy P5, execute. So after P5 is executed, whatever P5 was having resources, it will give me back. So that's what you can see. 7 plus 0 equals to 7. 4 plus 0 equals to 4. 3 plus 2 equals to 5. So now P2 executed. P4 executed. P5 is also executed. So now come back for P1. So add all this. What is current available for us? 5, 7, 4, 5 is available right now with me. How many A's? 7. How many B's? 4. How many C's? 5. Now check. Can I give for P1? P1, what is required? 7, 4, 3. Is it available? 7, 4, 3? Yes, it is available. Now add 7, 4, 3. Yes, if I give 7, 4, 3, even P1 will also execute. Means, Asta will complete her work if I give 7 A's, 4 B's, 3 C's. Is it available with me? Yes, right now available with me is 7, 4, 5. If I give to her, she will complete. So when she completes, whatever resources before I have given, she will return me back. Add that. 7 plus 0, 7. 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 0, 5. So right now, after Asta completed her work, whatever resources she was having, she has given me back and I have added right now. So what is the total right now we have? We have 7, 5, 5. So now, we have completed. What is the sequence? P1 is executed. So now P1, 2 over, 4 over, 5 over, 1 over. Now left over is what? P3. Come to P3. How much P3 resource is required? 6, 0, 0. So if I give 6 A's, 0 B's, 0 C's, then P3 will be completed or executed. So available with me is what? 7, 5, 5. Okay, if I give only 7 A's, 6 A's, that's sufficient for P3 to execute. So 7 plus 3 is 10. B is what? 5 plus 0 equals to 5. C equals to 5 plus 2 is 7. So now we have executed all. You can see P2 is executed. After P2, P4 is executed. After P4, P5 is executed. After P5, P1 is executed. After P1, P3 is executed. So this sequence we can execute to avoid deadlock. That's what I'm cross verify. what was initially we have, what was our initial resources. You can see here A was initially 10. After executed everything, we have 10. Yes, 10. Initially we were having 5. After executing all, we have 5. Yes, we have all. C, how many? 7. So initially 7. So I can see 10 5 5, and initially 10 5 7 is the one which is available with us right now for executing. So that's what this algorithm says. It is a safe. Means there is no deadlock. Deadlock will not occur if you follow. First, if you execute P2, after P3, P4, after that P5, after that P1, after that P3, then there is no deadlock occurring in this sequence. Is clear, Asta and Nishant? Is it clear for you how this is happening? Is this clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now come back. We take one more example. So this, I made it very simple so that it should be able to understand you, how you are able to see. What happened? Nishant is sending message. Yes, ma'am. Okay. So now come back. Same thing, but different ways. Now you see, I have 5 processors here. How many processors I have? I have 5 processors. So available, how much already allocated? P0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. P0, P1, P2, P3, P4. So how many resources right now we have? A resources. What is A? A stands for CPU. B stands for your memory. C stands for your printer. How many A's? Instances means copies. How many CPUs I have? 10 CPUs. How many memories I have? 5. How many printers we have? C stands for printers, if we assume. How many like that? 7. So now, so you can see first table, 3.1 table, initially how many processor? 5 processor. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. How many resources already we have assigned for each of the processors? What is the maximum required? Now, if I assume P0 is Asta, P1 is Nishant, P2 is me, P3 is someone, Benita, P4 is Bargan. So, if I say all these are different processors, what is Asta require? How much resources she require? She required 7 CPUs maximum to complete her work. 5, what is this 5 I told? Memory. 5 memory she required to complete her job. What is C? C is printer. How much maximum is required for Asta to complete her work? She want 7 CPUs, 5 memory, 3 printers. If I give to Asta, she will complete. So that's what here you can see P0 is having 753. Similarly, Nishant, how much Nishant is required to complete his work? He requires 3 CPUs, 2 memory, 2 printers. That's what here maximum, third column. That's what 573322. How much? If you give me, I will complete my work. I want 9 A's. What is 9 A? 9 CPUs I require. I don't want any memory. I want 2 printers to complete my job. That's what P2 will be doing. Similarly, Debelina, she wants 2 A's, 2 B's, 2 C's to complete her work. That's what she will complete. P4, she wants 4 A's, 3 B's, 3 C's to complete her work. This is maximum. What is the maximum column says to us? How much maximum is required to complete our job? So before maximum, some resources already we have given to Asta. How much already we have given? That's what you can see allocation. First column, first table, 3.1 table, second column, there is something called as allocation. Means before we have already allocated. How much we have allocated for Asta? 0, 1, 0. What is 0? And she don't want, we have not allocated A's. We have allocated only one B for Asta, no C's. We have given already to her. Similarly, Nishant, how much we have allocated for Nishant? We have allocated 2. 2 A's we have allocated. C, B we have not given to him. C we have not given. Similarly, how much resources is allocated for P2 for me? Already 3 is given, 3 A's are given. Then 0, B's are 0. C's are what? 2. So that's what here is given. Similarly for P3, how much allocated, already allocated? 2 A's is already allocated. How many B's are allocated? 1. How many C's are allocated? 1. Similarly, P4. Now Bhargavi, how much she has allocated? She already allocated 0 A's, 0 B's, 2 C's we have allocated. So if you add all these, you can see how much 2 plus 3 plus 2 is how much? 2. P1 is A's. Calculate all A's, calculate all B's, calculate all C's. What is A here? 0 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2 plus 0. How much? How many A's? Total 7. Second column. First table, second column, add all A's. If we add 0, 2, 3, 2, 0. Adding all this is how much is answer? 7. Yes? How much I have A's already? 10. 10 minus 7 is what? 3. That's what your last column in the first table, you can see 3 A's. Same way, add all B's. 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. So what are the values we have? 2. 2 B's is already allocated. So now what remaining, how many I have? 5. 5 minus 2 is what? 3. That's what you can see. Remaining 3 is there. Initially, I was having 10 A's, 5 B's, 7 C's. Out of this, already we have assigned something and which is left over. Now left over is 3, 3, 2. What is this 2? Again, add all this. So once you add 0 plus 0 plus 2 plus 1 plus 2, how much? 5. 5. 7 minus 5 is how much? 2. That's what you can see. Current available with the operating system, the resources are 3, 3, 2. How many? What is A? 3 CPUs. It is there right now. How many memories right now is available? 3 memories is available. How many printers are available? 2 printers are available. Okay. First table is clear. Table 3.1, what it says? What is maximum needed for all the processor to complete their job? Initially, I have assigned something. And what was first starting A? How many A's was there? How many B's was there? How many C's was there? Out of this, how much already allocated? 2 minus, that's what your current available. The third column, 3, 3, 2 is right now available. Okay. Now come back, need. Now I have given how many to Asta? How much resources is given to Asta already? She has 1 B. How much still she require? What was her maximum need? She require 7, 4, 3. Means maximum she wants 7 A's, 5 B's, 3 C's. But right now, how much we have already given? We have given only B for Asta. Yes, only 1 B we have given. Still, how much I have to give? We have to give for Asta? We have to give 7, 4, 3. At least here, 3.2 table need matrix. What is this need matrix? Is maximum. This one, maximum. In the 3.1 column, we have a maximum. Minus allocated. What is allocated already to Asta? So what is maximum? She wants 7, 5, 3. These many resources Asta require to complete her work. But how much we have allocated to her? We have allocated already 1. What 1? 1 B we have allocated. So subtract maximum. maximum she requires 753. 7 minus 0 is 7. 5 minus 1 is 4. 3 minus 0 is 3. So maximum need for Asta right now to complete her work is 743. Okay. Similarly, Nishant required maximum. What was the Nishant maximum required? He required 3 A's, 2 B's, 2 C's. How much already we have given to Nishant? We have already given 2 A's to Nishant. Now, how much still he require? Maximum minus allocation will give us how much Nishant is required. So, how much he requires? A 3. How much we have already given? 2. So, 3 minus 2 is what? 1. Did we allocate B? No. So, 2 minus 0 is 2. Did we allocate C? No. 2 minus 0 is 2. Now, if I give remaining, for Nishant 1, 2, 2, then Nishant work will be done. Like this, we have to calculate rest of the processors. Similarly, how much I require to complete my job? Maximum was 9 A's. I don't want B. I want 2 C's. How much already given to me? I have given 3, 0, 2. 3 A's is given. I don't want Z, B, so it is not allocated. I allocated 2. Minus this, how much is left over to me? Still required is 6 A's. I don't want B's. I don't want C because already given to me 2. I have completed C work. That's what still remaining. How much I should have been? I should be allocated resources. I want 6 A's, B 0, C 0. Then only I will complete my job. So the same way P3. P3 is how much? P3 asked maximum 2, 2, 2. It requires 2 A's, 2 B's, 2 C's to complete its work. But what we have given initially already for P3, we have given 2 A's, 1 B's, 1 C. Subtract 2 minus 2 is 0. Then 2 minus 1 is 1. The same way 2 minus 1 is 1. So, still, how much I have to give for P3 to complete its work? 0, 1, 1 resources I have to give to P3 to complete its work. That's what there in the table 3.2 need matrix. Last one, P4. How much still I have to give for P4 to complete its work? So maximum how much was required for P4? 4, 3, 3. Already we have given what? 0, 0, 2. Subtract this with this, then it will complete. 4 minus 0 is 4. 3 minus 0 is 3. 3 minus 2 is 1. So in the same way, 4, 3, 1 is required for P4 to complete its work. Okay. Now come to new states. What is this new state? That's what I told you. To make it clear, I gave you this one. New states for this table. Table 3.3, how can we calculate? What is a need? What is a need for to complete P0? 4743 is needed for P0 to complete its job. How much is balance with us now? Balance is 332. Can I give for P0? No, I don't. I have how many A's? 3 A's I have. How many B's I have? 3 B's. How many C's I have? 2 C's. No, I cannot give for P0 right now. Okay. Now come to P1. P1 require how much? 0, 2, 1. So can I give here in this table? You can see 1, 2, 2. I can give P1 1. Yes, P1 for P1 processor, how much still I have to give? I have to give 1, 2, 2. How much is available with me? 3, 3, 2. Can I give? Yes, I can give. 1 A's is right now available with me is 3, 3, 2. Can I give for P1? Yes, I can give. So now P1 will be executed first, not P0, P1. Okay, when I give for P1, it will give me back something. What it will give me back? It will give me back 2, whatever I have initially gave, it will give me back 2 A's. Add to the existing. Now, how many will be my total? 5, 3, 2. Check with 6, P2. P2, how much it requires? 600. But what I have? 5, 3, 2. Not possible. Now come for P3. P3, how much? 0, 1, 1. Is it possible? Yes. 5, 3, 2 I have. So it is possible. Execute. Then whatever P3 was there. How much P3 was there? 2, 1, 1. Add to the existing. What I was having? 5, 3, 2 was there. Add 2, 1, 1. 5 plus 2, 7. 3 plus 1, 4. 2 plus 1, 3. So now total available because P3 completed. Once it completes, it will give me back the resources what I have allocated. I have allocated 2, 1, 1. So now total will be 7, 4, 3. 7, 4, 3. Now I give any for P4. Yes, 4, 3, 1. Yes, I can give to P4. Now P1 completed, P3 completed, P4 completed. Now again come back to P2. So P2, can I give 600? Yes, available with me, complete P2. Then finally come back to P1, complete. So this is what the sequence is. Sequence is for us to complete the execution of all these process. Suppose now the process makes a request 102 to check whether this request can be immediately granted. We can apply resource request algorithm if we assume that this request is fulfilled. The new state would be shown in the table 3.3. So that's what this is how the new state will be given to us if we have completed all the work. Is this Banker's algorithm clear for you? This is clear for you. That's the reason I took it. Two example. This is one example where I showed you what is allocation, what is maximum required, how much is available, how much still I have to give, then this is one. So in this case, what is Banker's algorithm is doing? Banker's algorithm is used to check whether there is a deadlock or not. So that's the reason we are using. Why the Banker's algorithm is used? Banker's algorithm is used to check whether there is a deadlock or not. And also we are using a Banker's algorithm to check whether which sequence means which one should I execute first. So that's what in this example we have executed first P2, then P4, then P5, then P1, then P3. So this is a safe sequence. What do we mean by safe sequence? Safe sequence means there is no deadlock. That's the reason it is called as a safe sequence. So that's what a safe sequence. What is unsafe sequence? Unsafe sequence means it is occurring a deadlock. That's what here this example gives us the whether a deadlock is occurred, is not occurred. So which sequence I have to execute? So now suppose if I take one more example, we have 3, Nishant, Asta and me. So which one should be given first? Should first Asta should execute her work, or Nishant should execute, or me should execute? So this is how, if I give which one first, there will be no deadlock. If all 3 executed our work without deadlock, then we call it as a safe sequence. That's what here in this example. What is a safe sequence? Safe sequence is first you execute P2. After P2, P4 is executed. After P4, P5 is executed. After P5, P1 is executed. After P1, P3 is executed. This sequence, whatever the safe sequence is there, this sequence will not have a deadlock. So that's the reason it is called as a safe sequence. So unsafe sequence means what? Deadlock can occur. That's what a unsafe sequence is. So why do we use a Banker's algorithm? banker's algorithm is used to check whether there is a deadlock or no deadlock. There is a deadlock is there. Can I say whether deadlock is there in this problem or no deadlock? If it is there, and which sequence if I take, I can avoid deadlock. That's the reason banker's algorithm is a deadlock detection, and deadlock avoidance algorithm is a banker's algorithm. So I'll stop this now. So we'll continue in our next class about resource allocation graph. So this is a banker's algorithm. Same way, we have one more algorithm called as a resource allocation graph. So that's what is called as a deadlock detection algorithm. So in that, we have a single instance and multiple instance. We'll see that in our next class. So I'll stop here now. We'll continue in the next class.